Because the paradox, I told you what I said, a paradox is some way it can be conflicting. But see, the paradox in the word is not really designed to be conflicting. It may appear conflicting, but you got to also keep reading. Keep reading, because there is a goal of why you go through. There is a goal why I must go through. You're not going through just to be going through. That's another thing you have to understand. God takes us through because he's trying to build us. God takes us through because he's trying to shape us. God takes us through because he's trying to mold us and make us understand who he is. God takes us through because he recognizes that if he doesn't take us through anything, we will not mature, will not grow. How are you going to have a testimony and never have a test?
Right.
How? Churches all over the place now. Grace and love and all this graciousness, and you don't have to suffer. But the Bible said that they that will live God
must
suffer persecution. And I'm not no advocate of persecution. I don't want to suffer. I don't want to be beaten. I don't want to go through. But how many of you know, just like the apostles of old, when Jesus walked among them and said, if you forsake family and
friends
and loved ones in this world, God said that I'll give you 100-fold return. I'll give you 50, 100-fold on you and your suffering for me. Because you can't do more for God than he do for you.
Come on.
You can't suffer for God and God don't turn around and recompense your reward. You can't do more for him and don't expect him to come back and do for you, because he is a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. He's a rewarder, and he has a way of rewarding us when we stand and when we hold on. Because see, that's what the paradox is all about. Conflict, God stirs up conflict in us, because he's stirring up conflict because he wants us to do better. He wants us to go higher. Then the scripture talks about in Corinthians, where it talks about how we should provoke each other to greater works. Don't you know, when you provoke somebody, that stirs up a conflict? Why I gotta do that? Why you want me to do it, Bishop? Bishop Cooper, wait, Bishop Cooper asked me to do such another thing. Why I got to do it? Why he don't ask Sister so-and-so, Brother so-and-so? But that's because he's trying to stir you to greater works. Trying to get you to your next level. Trying to get us in the place we need to be. Because see, God most of the time have to chase us out of the things that we in. Sometimes he got to chase us to our next level. Sometimes he got to set the dogs loose and say, go get it. And see how far you run spiritually now.
Get your head up.
Just to see, what are we going to do?
What are you going to do?
Are we going to cower and say, I'm scared, I don't know what to do, I'm done, I can't make it? Or are we going to say, let me do what I can. Let me get the word. Let me get out here and pray. Let me ask God to give me some direction. What do I need to do? What is Bishop Cooper asking me? Where is he taking me? What is my calling? Where do you want me to fit in this great body of believers? That's what we got to do, saints, if you intend to make it. That's what you got to do, because you can't make it out there on your own. See, most of the time, we as a people, and this is not being racist, but as a people, we run from challenge. We run from conflict. We run from things that challenge us from doing where we need to be. We run because we're afraid. We run because we feel like I can't give him up. We run because I feel like I can't give that up. We run because I can't, God, that can't happen. It's helpless and I can't let it go. We run. But see, God is telling you, don't run from it. Don't run from trial. Because trial and challenge is where your promotion is at. Your promotion is not outside of that. Some of you want to be great things in God. You want to be devotional leaders. You want to be preachers. You want to be this, that, or whatever. But you will never get to your level until you learn how to embrace challenge and embrace conflict and not allow conflict to always get the best of you. We've got to learn how to take conflict and use it for good. You got to learn how to take conflict when things are being, when you're being pushed and you're being tried. That's not the point to say I'm mad at the preaching, I'm leaving, because he hurt my feelings and made me upset. He didn't talk to me the right way. He didn't do me the right way. So I'm mad at you and I'm mad at God. I'm taking my little time and I'm getting out of here. You're a fool. You're a fool.